Welcome to the React TextArea tutorial. The Syncfusion React TextArea is an input element that allows you to enter multiple lines of text in a designated area. Easily share your valuable comments, messages, and any longer text content you need to convey. In this video, I will show you how to create a React app and add the Syncfusion React TextArea component to it. I will also show you a few of its features, like floating labels, resize modes, validation states, the read-only state, and disable the component. Before proceeding, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a React application using the npx create react app command. I name it my React app. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the TextArea component, I need to install the React inputs package. So I run the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2react-inputs --save. Before using any Syncfusion React component, I need to register a trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion ej2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. For instructions on how to generate a trial key, refer to the link in this video's description. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. After that, I import the TextArea component from the Syncfusion ej2 React Inputs package and include the TextArea component tag inside the division tag. To add the CSS reference for the TextArea component, I open the app.css file and remove the default styles. Then I import the material theme CSS reference. After that, in the app.tsx file, I set the width to 200 pixels and the placeholder value to enter your comments in the TextArea component tag. To align the component, in the app.css file, I define the styles text, align, and padding. Now let me save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. You can see the text area with the placeholder value enter your comments. Next, let me show you the TextArea's three validation states, success, warning, and error. To use any of these states, just set the CSS class property with one of the built-in classes, eSuccess, eWarning, or eError. Here, I have set the eSuccess class to show the success TextArea. I also changed the placeholder property value to success. To display the warning and error state, let me copy and paste the TextArea component tag. And for the warning state, change the CSS class to eWarning. I also change the placeholder value to warning. For the error state, update it with the eError class and change the placeholder value to error. You can see three text areas with the three validation states. When I begin typing in one of them, the placeholder value disappears. I can customize the visibility of the placeholder text using the float label type property. Text area supports three types of float label visibility: always, auto, and never. Let me show you how they work. In the first TextArea component tag, I add the property float label type and set the value to always. In the placeholder value, I change the value to always so that I can tell which type of float label is assigned to the TextArea. In the second TextArea component tag, I add the property float label type and set the value as auto. I change its placeholder property value to auto. In the third TextArea component tag, I add the property float label type and set the value as never. In the placeholder property, I change the value to never. You can see the first TextArea with the placeholder value always. The placeholder text floats above the TextArea at all times. In the second TextArea, the placeholder text will automatically move upward when I enter a value. In the third TextArea, the placeholder value disappears once I enter a value. Now let's see how to customize the row and column counts in the TextArea. First, I will remove the second and third TextArea component tags from here to make this easier to understand. To change the row and column counts, I add the rows property and set the value to 3. Then I add the calls property and set the value to 50. I also change the float label type and placeholder values for better clarity. You can now see the TextArea's row and column counts are customized as specified. Now I will show you the different resize modes. The TextArea component supports 4 resize modes: vertical, horizontal, both, and none. By default, the resize mode is none. To change the resize mode, I add the resize mode property and set its value to both. See, now I can resize the TextArea vertically and horizontally. By default, users can type as many characters as they want in the TextArea. To limit the number of characters allowed, you can use the max length property. I add the max length property and set its value to 8. See, now I am not able to enter more than 8 characters in the TextArea. To prevent editing the TextArea value, I enable the read-only property and set a default value using the value property. I also comment out the placeholder property. You can see the TextArea is now in a read-only state and the user cannot edit the value. Still, you can use the gripper to resize the TextArea. Finally, I will show you how to disable the TextArea. I add the enabled property and set its value to false. Now we can't interact with the TextArea at all. In this video, I have shown you how to add the Syncfusion React TextArea component to a React application. I also showed you a few of its basic features. If you want to try the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description for this video. I have also shared a link to learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite through our community license if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel.